Somebody call 911. Quick, help me get her out of the water. I don't feel a pulse. I think she's dead.
Hello, Detective. We called you in to investigate the death of Veronica West. Yeah, it looks like a suicide. But we can't leave anything to chance with such a high-profile figure. Agent Daniels is here to help you out. I've heard about your track record together. Very impressive. Miss West had a birthday party last night at her estate on Silvermoon Island. See what you can find out there. Oh, and keep a low profile.
Mrs. West's party guests are still on the island. Every one of them is a potential suspect. If you find anything out, keep it under wraps until we narrow it down. First things first, though, we need to get to the island in one piece. The storm is really picking up. I can hardly see through the fog. I'll need you to be my navigator. The map should be on the table, and you can use the compass from my briefcase. This isn't the right way. Keep looking. Great work, partner. I can see the lighthouse from here. Looks like we made it. Engine's dead. Why don't you go on ahead? I'll hang back and try to get this thing working again so we'll have a ride home. Take a good look around, but focus on the grounds first. Veronica ended up in the ocean, so there might be some evidence near the water. Oh, and here's your badge. You must have dropped it.
Welcome to Silvermoon Isle, Detective. I'm Evelyn Clark, Veronica's maid. It's a shame we have to meet under these circumstances. I can't believe what happened to Veronica. I've been crying all night. All right, fine. I'm sad, but not that sad. Veronica and I got along, but she didn't pay me nearly enough for everything I did for her. You know how it is. I saved up. A girl can treat herself from time to time, can't she? Anyway, I have to get going. The mansion is a mess after the party. Is there anything else I can help you with? Oh yes, I almost forgot. Here's a list of everyone who was on the island when Veronica died. If you need me, I'll be inside.
Detective, finally. I know you'll figure this all out. I'm sorry I'm such a mess. I was crying all night. I didn't have the strength to clean myself up. I just can't believe she's gone. My little sister. I had to rely on an old natural remedy to calm myself down. I should have seen it coming. She always felt so alone. Sometimes it was like I was the only one who truly cared about her. It's nice to have someone to turn to during hard times. Mr. Hart? Oh, no. No, it's not what you think. He's the family lawyer. There's nothing between us. He'll tell you the same if you ask him. Now, you'll have to excuse me. I'm not feeling very well.
Hello, you must be the detective. I'm Thomas Hart, Veronica's attorney. I handled all of her financial matters. Oh, and please don't mind Sylvia. She's just rattled. This whole situation is too much for her. We were talking about the inheritance and, well, she really heats up during arguments, as evidenced by the flying ashtray. But she'll cool down eventually.
Hey, partner. I hope you're making some progress. I'm gonna take a look around. So, the lawyer and the stepdaughter were having a fight? Interesting. We should definitely look into that later. The old boat still isn't fixed. I'm not giving up on her yet, though. The door to the engine compartment is stuck. I've tried everything. Maybe you'll have better luck. Thank you.
Excuse me? Who are you? I thought I'd be alone up here. That's why I locked the door. Oh, so you're the detective everyone's talking about. Sorry, I didn't realize. I came to pay my final respects. This is where Veronica was, all alone, until she jumped. I just wish I knew why. Yes, we were in love. After I met Veronica, I never even wanted to look at another woman. What? That's not mine. I don't know how that got into my pocket. I have to go.
Did you hear that? It sounded like a gunshot, and it came from the garden. There's no one here, but look at those footprints. They head toward the wall. Say, that's some nice work, Flatfoot. I knew that wall looked odd. He's still breathing. Quick, get some bandages. We've got to stop the bleeding.
My word, what's happened here? Is he hurt?
Step aside, I'm a doctor.
He's lost a lot of blood. Quick, I'm going to need help from both of you. Ray, you hold him down. Detective, you give me a hand. We've got to get that bullet out. Detective, there in my bag, there's a pair of surgical scissors. I have to cut his shirt off.
Detective,
First, we need to anesthetize him. Here, mix this sedative. Now to clean the wound. Bring me a bottle of high-proof alcohol, whatever you can find. That'll do. Now hand me the forceps. He should be all right. Let's patch him up. Stabilized, but we should take him up to my office so I can monitor his condition. Ray, help me get him up.
The bar's locked, and I haven't even started in there yet. I'll get to it once I'm done here. What a mess. All I ever do is clean up after these lazy rich people.
Thank you.
Detective, I'm Sylvia Crawford, Veronica's stepdaughter. I wandered in here looking for the music box Daddy gave me when I was just a girl. The door locked behind me. I'm feeling claustrophobic. I need to sit down for a minute. But I've got to find that music box. Detective, you found it! Oh, thank you. First, I lost Daddy, and now Veronica. Don't listen to those awful gossips who say Veronica and I hated each other. I assure you it's not true. I'm in mourning. Veronica and I were kindred spirits, really. She was there for me when I felt lonely, and she supported me artistically. Yes, that's mine. But I was planning to give it to Veronica as a sign of gratitude, since she always gave me such nice jewelry. It's as light as air. I don't even feel it on my wrist. Oh, this? It's nothing. It's clumsy old me. I'm not confrontational at all. All I can tell you...
You've crossed a line, Detective. Sylvia had nothing to do with this.
I don't feel so good, Ray. I need some water.
I'll take...
I'm just here to see Ray. I thought he'd be in his room. I had his key, but left it in my office. Oh, so you have his key. I know how this looks, but I'm really just checking up on Ray, out of respect for the late Miss West. I don't care about the money, not like Ray. A lawyer in my position can afford a few nice things. I wasn't exclusively Miss West's attorney, you know. And I have a fine relationship with everyone in this household. Me? Hurt Sylvia? I should think not. The one to finger is Ray. He and Sylvia have a history, if you know what I mean. He was only marrying Veronica for her money. Old Ray's flat broke. See for yourself.
Thanks. Dr. May prescribed these to Sylvia. I like to keep an eye on her. We're old friends.
You've got a sharp eye for detail. There's no point denying it. Ray and I fell in love. But Veronica knew. We told her.
We had to sneak around to keep it out of the tabloids. Veronica was helping me out financially.
Ray was with me that night. Some people in this house have a grudge against him.
Hart's a little weasel. Barely a man, that one. Veronica left everything to Sylvia. It's all in the will. He's desperate to get his hands on it, so we hid it in the safe upstairs. See for yourself.
About Veronica West. I've heard them say I'm a tough nut to crack. There's no tough shell here. I'm just a girl, still getting used to the taste of champagne. I'm learning that high society is where the real acting happens. Everyone's pretending. I remember when life was simpler, when the highlight of my day was Daddy bringing home a candy bar. Now it's one party after another. Only no one's really dancing. I'd never be able to say these things in public. And everything I say is public. So, I lock it in here and throw away the key.
Thank you.
such shocking developments in this house. First, Veronica, and now this. You must be here to check on your partner. He's stable, but still in a lot of pain. I've kept him heavily sedated. Don't worry, I have a lot of experience in these matters. I've been treating Veronica since I retired. Ancient history. Miss West knew, but it didn't bother her. She trusted me. Yes, that's the bottle, but that's the wrong medication. I believe someone's tampered with it. Veronica had severe anxiety. Yes, the necklace. Mr. Hart will know more. He keeps insurance records on all the family. You better call the station and ask for medical assistance, just to be sure. There's an old radio in the living room if you need it.
Ah, Detective. It's good of you to check in. I'm sending backup right away, but there's a storm raging, so hang in there, right?
You. I've locked myself in here so we couldn't get in. I've never trusted him. That's before I realized he's a conniving backstabber who is just taking advantage of my sister. Help me look for evidence. In Veronica's room. I can't find the key, though. Hart probably hid it.
Thank you.
happens. What do you think you're doing in my room? You should be searching for Veronica's murderer. Surely you don't think I had anything to do with it. It's not mine. Someone planted it here. It must have been Thomas Hart. He's trying to make me look guilty. Didn't belong to Veronica. All right. I stole from everyone else, but never from her. I have no other choice. Sorry for this, Detective.
May. The lab. Ugh. got the doc, too? It was Hart. He's the one who shot me. Hey, I heard some noise coming from upstairs. Let's go see. We've got our suspects. I'll go after Evelyn, and you find that lawyer. Here, take this.
You? But how? I had it all figured out. Don't look at me like that. I really need this money. I didn't think anybody'd notice. No harm done. Oh, you and your ethics. You're just like your partner. So high and mighty. It was an accident, I swear. I never meant to shoot him. I was only trying to bribe him, and when he refused, I panicked. She made me do it. That's right. It was Vivian. We were going to escape together, but I guess I'm not making that trip.
It's about time, Hart. Another minute and I'd have left. Oh, hi, Detective. What brings you out here? Arrest me? But why on earth would you do that? I'm innocent. That? It's nothing. A little accident on my way over here. I stumbled a bit and tore my coat. You can't possibly believe I'd murder my own sister. You're shrewd, Detective. But there's one thing missing. Motive. I can't believe you think I'd kill for something as trivial as a pile of cash. I'll tell you what really happened. I lost my sister to that little twit, Sylvia. But I finally did it. Got my revenge. And I tied up all the loose ends. Or so I thought. Dr. May saw me that night and he tried to blackmail me. I didn't want to kill him. But I had to. Veronica deserved her fate. She never loved me anyway. She was the only family I had left.
Detective, you deserve a medal.